It's the NFL on EA Sports, where representatives from the AFC and NFC will square off. It's the Miami Dolphins and the Los Angeles Rams on Monday Night Primetime. If you're a freeway fan, we're just east of the 405. One of the modern jewels of the NFL. Beautiful SoFi Stadium in Inglewood. Good to be in the booth with my partner Greg Olson. I'm Mike Tirico. Welcome, and Greg, this is one of those that's worthy of prime time because wide receivers love the spotlight as much as any position group in the league. And we got two guys who shine under the lights here tonight.
And I think where it's going to be really fun and get interesting to watch, Mike, is in those critical situations, the game's on the line, third down, red zone, gotta have it moments. There is no mystery. Both these sidelines, they know exactly where the ball's going, and they're just going to say, I dare you to stop them. These are two prime, elite wide receivers in the National Football League. Night game, prime time, they're looking to put on a show.
Here is the rookie out of Stanford, Joshua Cardi, to get us started. And off we go from SoFi. And they'll be set up well as he is past the 35-yard line. The Dolphins come out on offense, and the lefty, Tua Tagovailoa. He led the NFL a year ago in passing yardage. Hard to believe this is season 5 already from Alabama, Greg. Tua, 26 years old, and his time is now.
One of the few southpaws we have playing quarterback in the NFL, Mike, and while he doesn't have one of the strongest arms, he makes up for it with great anticipation and pinpoint accuracy. So what it does, it allows him to throw very catchable balls. A lot of his receivers do a lot of the damage after the catch, and only time's going to tell how this one plays out. But when he's on his game, they get after him right away, and definitely goes on the first play of the game. It's first down. You got to get the ball out of your hands. I understand trying to take a shot. I love it on early downs. But once it's not there and that protection starts to break down, it's either check down or throw away. You don't want to be in second and long.
Work to do now as they come up on second and long. Second-year man, Devon Achane. Mm-hmm. And he's taken down, but just shy of midfield.
This is one of those cases where having high-end speed in the backfield can be such a game-changer. The offensive linemen don't need to hold their blocks quite as long. You give this guy a little bit of a crease, and man, he is gone.
Here's first and 10. Hill brought in motion. Play action, it's Tagovailoa. Oh, a sure throw there, but it's going to end up incomplete. That's a pass he, say he should have had. Instead, he does not, and it brings up second down.
As you can probably imagine, Mike, this one really burns me. I mean, man, I wish my fellow tight ends catch every ball the entire game, but to be this open and not come down with it, I'm going to have to set a reminder. Next year at TEU, we're going to have to bring out some jugs machines. I know this play results in an incomplete pass, but I think this is a really good job by the quarterback. His clock was going off. He felt that rush. He had no immediate target to go to with the ball. Instead, throw it away. Don't take the sack. Live for another day.
Throwing on third down, Tagovailoa. To the left side, in the hands of Hill. So on fourth down, it's Jake Bentley to punt for the Dolphins. And this is going to work out for him. Out of bounds, and they'll mark it inside the 10. The Rams led out by a Super Bowl champion, Matthew Stafford. Second among all active passers in the NFL. Only Aaron Rodgers has thrown for more yards. Hard to believe, Greg, it's already season 16 for the man out of the University of Georgia.
The coaches spend all week, Mike, drafting up their opening script. These are the plays that they feel the best with to not only attack the defense early, but try to get an idea of what sort of matchups they're going to see throughout the course of the game. Now, all of that is thrown out the window. None of the plays take into account snapping it this close to your own goal line. They've got to try to get themselves some breathing room, pick up a first down or two. That will allow them to get back on track executing the rest of that opening script.
We'll try again. It's second and 10. Working out of the gun, Stafford. Oh, and this one's going to wind up incomplete. That's one you'd think he'd be able to corral. He can't find the handle, and it's going to lead to a third down.
Unfortunately, Mike, over my career, I've been in this guy's shoes plenty of times, probably more than I wish to admit. You take your eyes off the ball. You think about becoming a runner before securing the catch, and when you do that, you end up watching the ball fall to the ground.
They'll be forced to just throw that one away. It's incomplete.
It's been a bit of a pedestrian game for this quarterback and ultimately this passing game here today, Mike. And I know they all would have loved to connect on that deep throw. I think that stat sheet would have looked a whole lot different, but just a little off in their execution and leads to an incompletion.
On the return, here's Washington. And he's going to be brought down after a short return. And that's where his team will get possession of the football. First and 10. In motion comes Beckham. Off play action, it's Tua. He's going to let it fly downfield for Beckham. And out of bounds, but in business. They're going to have it first and goal inside the five. It's a big play there for Miami. An even 40 yards.
They certainly wasted no time trying to take advantage of that great field position, and I love it. So often we see teams either in sudden change or when they have a shorter field to go, they want to strike early. There is such a correlation in the NFL, Mike, between explosive plays and your ability to end drives with points.
Here's Achane. And he'll punch forward to the two, setting up second and goal. A little closer. Here's second and goal. Out of the gun, Tagovailoa. He'll be forced to just throw that one away. It's incomplete.
He went for it all on that one and just a little bit off. Ball winds up hitting the ground. They've got to move forward. The opportunities are out there. Better execution, better location, and we got some big plays in their future.
They'll run with Achane. Powering forward, he's in. Devon Achane, touchdown Miami. So on third and goal, they run it in. Sometimes, Greg, that's four down territory. They didn't need to do it on fourth down, taking care of it on the third down for the touchdown.
Yeah, and when you find yourself down here this close, Mike, you have to finish these drives off. I'm with you. I think he was going to give his back two shots there to punch it in, but he only needed one.
Jason Sanders on for the point after. He's got it. And the Dolphins will take a 7-0 lead. after the touchdown, Myers is back to boot this one away. He fields it at the 8. And he'll be set up well as he is past the 35-yard line. First and 10 now from the 36. Out of the gun, Stafford. A throw here, right side, falls incomplete. He'll try again here, second and 10. The NFL's third leading rusher a season ago, it's Kyren Williams. A nice pickup, moving it across the 40. We'll give him 6 on that play. Here's a third down and 4. Here's Stafford. He's going to find his receiver. It's Robinson. 11 yards on the connection there. First down, L.A.
Back-to-back 3-and-outs, and not ideal to start the game in that manner. So that's a really important throw right there. Let's see if they can build something from there. Brings up first and 10. Continue to let your opening script unfold. You got to go down and find some points here and get your offense settled down.
On the handoff, it is Williams running to the right. And the defense all over this one. They knock him down. It'll go down as a loss of 2. Last play went the wrong way. It sets up second and long. It's second down and 12. It's another run here for Williams. He'll maneuver his way down to the 44. Jalen Ramsey up to make the play. They're going to try to pick this up on 3rd and 8. From the gun, here's Stafford. Gonna get to him and take him down, taken back to the other side of midfield. That's the rookie out of Penn State, Chop Robinson, in for the sack.
The offense is trying to stretch the field vertically. They're trying to put as many receivers into the coverage deep as possible. But you know what you need? You need time. You need to allow those guys to get downfield. But when you have a pass rush like this, they don't let that time unfold, and that pocket collapsed and results in a sack.
And we will not have a return here. This one angled out of bounds. Operating from their own 23, they'll begin 1st and 10. They'll motion the tight end, Smith. 2 and out on 1st down. That one into the hands of Hill. Following the completion, we'll get a stoppage here for an injured player. As the athletic training staff looks at him, we'll step away for a moment. They'll come up here on 2nd down and 5. A shotgun snap to Tua. Sending it deep for Waddle. To the 20. And he's going to take this one all the way. A beautiful combination in the air there. The pass downfield and bringing it the rest of the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
And it's really just a great route, Mike, and then a beautiful throw. The accuracy of the throw is what allowed the receiver not only to secure the catch, but then be able to turn it up and finish the play and find himself in the end zone.
Sanders here for the extra point. It's up and through. And the Dolphins move out on top, 14-0. After the touchdown, Myers is back to boot this one away. Now return coming from the 7. That'll be brought down past the 25. Decent field position to start this drive. A fresh set of downs to work with. It is first down and 10. Drive begins with a run by Williams. And a knock him down just shy of the 40.
The ability to be effective on first down, Mike, it just makes everything else easier. In the event you do have to face a third down the road, they're usually a lot more manageable situations, a lot easier to convert.
So, from the 39, they come up on 1st and 10. From the shotgun, it's Stafford. That's to Robinson, he's got it. And they bring him down, but not until he crosses midfield.
It's so early in the game, you have to be careful now as coaches and players that you don't find yourself trailing early and get out of your game plan. There is so much time left. Stick to what you've worked on all week. There's plenty of time to chip away and see if you can make this thing close come the fourth quarter.
He'll find his tight end. It's Colby Parkinson.
You can see the eyes of the quarterback. He's trying to push this ball initially downfield, but with the defense doing a good job keeping a lid on the coverage, he's forced to check this ball down to the shallow route. But this is something that they know in the future. If I need a couple yards, they can come back to this play.
Second down, it's Stafford. That's to the right side, and incomplete. Third and 5. Again, it's Stafford. It's complete. He's got caught. He's going to have the first down. So they convert on third down with a pickup of 9. Bootleg, it's Stafford. Open man is Robinson. They'll break the huddle. It's 2nd and 5. To the air again, Stafford. And that's going to be incomplete. Coverage was good that time. The contact jarring the ball loose and forcing third down.
Well, it's pretty clear the main reason why they find themselves trailing in this game, Mike, has really just been the inefficiency of this offense. And primarily out of the quarterback position. I mean, to complete less than half of your pass attempts, it just makes it very hard to compete at a high level consistently in the NFL. And if they want to find themselves having any chance of getting back into this game and winning this one, he's going to have to get a lot better with the ball. As a play caller, those are the plays that just drive you crazy, Mike. You think you're going to pick up the first down, you get tackled just shy of the sticks, and now a little bit of a gamble here on fourth down.
Ah, early big play here. They're going to go for it on fourth down. They'll go for it. It's Williams. First down and more inside the 15. Now, following the run, one of the offensive linemen leading the way is a bit shaken up. So as they look at the injured player, we'll take a timeout. So, not quite first and goal. It's first and 10. They're pretty close. A shotgun snap to Stafford. This one caught at the 4.
Certainly not the biggest play of the day, but a good example of picking up positive yardage, staying ahead of the chains by a well-timed ball and a well-timed route.
This defense back up, but stepping up. No gain on the play. It stays at the 3.
So on second down, they try to hammer it in on the ground, Mike, but now on third and goal, I don't think you had any choice but to put this ball in your quarterback's hands and test this defense through the air.
Stafford now on third down. And that's going to line up. Catchable out of the back of the end zone. It's incomplete. So on comes Joshua Cardy to try this field goal. This about as short as you can get. Cardy's kick is good. And the Rams get their first points of the game. They trail 14-3. Cardy back out. Following the made field goal, he'll kick this one away. On the return, Malik Washington. And he's down at the 23, and that's where the offense will take over. They'll come up here, first and 10. They'll motion the tight end, Smith. On the ground to start the drive, it's A-Chain. That one never got started. Too much defensive pressure. They dropped him in the backfield.
Looked like that might have been an RPO, a run-pass option. The quarterback has the ability to put the ball in the belly of the running back or pull it on the pass. Looked like he might have been better off pulling that one because he handed it off and there was nowhere for that running back to go.
They'll motion the tight end, Smith. Tagovailoa working out of the pistol. They need 8 as they come up for third down. In motion, it's Waddle. A play fake. Now, two of the throw. He'll be forced to just throw that one away. It's incomplete. Here's Jake Bailey now. And John to punt for the second time in this opening quarter. Fair catch is called for and made just inside the 35-yard line. They'll start this on the ground. It's Williams. And he's going to be stopped in his tracks. He'll lose a couple of yards on that one. Here's a second and 12. Now to bootleg with Stafford. This one, caught by Parkinson. And that's a good game there. It's going to wind up just a couple of yards shy of that first down.
That quarterback called that play in the huddle. That ball was only going to one guy. He was the first read, the second read, and the check down. And it was called to perfection. They got the perfect look and led to a nice game.
They'll try to run for it with Williams. And he'll be taken down. And that's going to do it. That's the last play of the first quarter. So we've played one quarter here on a Monday night. 14-3 is the score. And we're back at SoFi in SoCal after this. Here's Ethan Evans now, as he is on to punt for the Rams. And no return forthcoming. It's a touchback and will come out to the 20-yard line. The break, the huddle. Coming up now for first and 10. Now it's Tua. He finds his tight end, that's Smythe. A very nice open field tackle there. He could not get free and gains nothing. Second down, here's Tagovailoa. Off to the left side there, not going to find the target. Incomplete. Jalen Waddle, the intended target. And third down coming up. In motion comes Beckham. Throwing on third down, Tagovailoa. That's caught! And he will take this one in. 80 yards. Touchdown, Miami. And that is number two. Greg, he is off to some kind of start in this one. Two quarters and two receiving touchdowns.
Mike, this is one of those situations where, as a defensive coordinator, you've got to give your group an answer, because right now, they don't have one for this guy.
Now, Sanders on for the extra point. He's got it. And the Dolphins move out to a 21-3 advantage. after the touchdown, Myers is back to boot this one away. This taken in at the 8-yard line. And he'll be brought down just beyond the 25-yard line. So they come to the line for first down and 10. A gift, and here comes Williams. He'll be brought down up past the 35-yard line.
Well, this is something we don't see every day, Mike. A team playing with a traditional I-formation fullback. It's kind of a lost art in today's modern game, but in this case, highly effective. Great job by the fullback clearing out the path for his running back, and they're able to pick up the first down.
Stafford now on first down.
If you want to be a top-notch NFL DB, of course, yes, the athleticism is a given, but it's really, you have to be instinctive. The instincts are what allow you to maximize those physical skills, and you saw him on full display right here, leading in the big-time breakup.
They'll run it with Williams. And that won't get a whole lot. Maybe a yard, but that's it. Third and 9. Working out of the gun, Stafford. That's over the middle and taken in. He's got it. It'll be taken down, but it takes them across midfield down to the 40-yard line.
It's been a rough first half, but now as we approach halftime, Mike, you got to start getting some wins, and it could be something small like we just saw here. Some positive plays, build a little confidence on that sideline, so as you go into halftime, you have something to build on.
It'll be a run out of the gun with Williams. And good blocking up front, paving the way for a gain of 8 on the ground. They'll come to the line now on 2nd and 2. Cup in motion. They'll go again with Williams. Now they are in business inside the 15-yard line.
What we're seeing here in this first half, Mike, is an example of the offensive line, the running back, and the play caller all on the same page. The execution and the ability to continue to pick up chunk plays on the ground has been a great start for this offense.
On the move at the 14-yard line, it's 1st and 10. Out of the gun, Stafford. And that ball incomplete over the middle. Cooper Kupp was the intended receiver. And it'll be 2nd down. Now it's Williams. And a determined run there. He gets about 7 yards inside the 10-yard line. Third down, 3 to go. Now it's Stafford. To the goal line and in. Puka Nacua. Touchdown, Los Angeles. Well, that is a step in the right direction, finding the end zone. I don't know, Greg, could this be building some momentum for these guys, and that's important before halftime?
Absolutely, and I think the biggest thing this coach is trying to get across right now on the sideline, Mike, is let's just cut into this lead, and let's make it a one-score game at half. So they still got some work to do, but if they can go into halftime, regroup, catch their breath, just keep it close. Give yourself a fighting chance here out of the break.
Joshua Cardy comes out now for the extra point. He gets it to go. And the Rams get a bit closer here. It's now 21-10. Here's Carney now. He'll kick it away following the touchdown. Here comes D. Eskridge on the return. He is past the 20, but there is a marker down. Let's get the call. Set to go now on 1st and 10. Hill brought in motion. On play action, it's Tagovailoa. That's taken in by Achane. He's not going to get too far, tackled after a gain of just a yard. Here's a 2nd and 9. Tua, will give it to Achan. He'll be stacked up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play.
Just watch the speed of the pursuit out of this safety on this tackle, Mike. His ability to play from depth and attack the line of scrimmage and meet that ball carrier in the hole and keep him to no gain. You don't see a lot of safeties able to make that tackle in the open field. That's pretty impressive.
In motion, it's Waddle. They fake the handle. Now, Tua. They'll be forced to just throw that one away. It's incomplete.
The offense just couldn't seem to get anything going that drive. They knew they had a long way to go, taking over possession that deep in their own territory. You want to pick up that first down and see if you can capitalize some momentum. Instead, the errant throw brings up 4th down, and they're going to have to punt it away.
Now, fair catch is called for and made right there at the 45. Kyren Williams and the Rams offense ready to get back to work. And he's been a tough man to stop in this first half, putting up some big numbers already. And remember, we haven't even reached halftime yet. On 1st down, it's Stafford. He'll take a shot here, back to the end zone. That's in the end zone and intercepted. Picked off by Kendall Fuller.
So much of that play comes down to the defender's positioning. Being able to get himself to a spot to get his hands on the ball and a chance at that pick. Mike, when that ball was thrown, me and you are sitting here saying, that's a touchdown, and instead, they force a turnover, and now their offense is back on the field.
The drive begins at the 20. His 1st and 10. Back to throw is Tua. And he's going to be marked down up around the 33.
This is a tale as old as time, Mike. It seems that anytime a team forces a takeaway, fumble, or interception, the ensuing drive starts with a shot, a deep play in the air to try to seize on some of that momentum. You just saw a great example of it here.
Hill brought in motion. Here comes the jet sweep. And he's going to be brought down up past the 45. Two first downs, and they're at the 46 now. It's first and 10. They'll motion the tight end, Smith. On first down, Tagovailoa. That's caught downfield by Smith. And they're going to move this ball inside the 25-yard line.
The most valuable real estate on the field, Mike, that every offense is trying to attack is the middle of the field. So when you have a tight end who's as good as this guy and you can get vertical down the middle, man, that is a nightmare for these defenses to deal with.
Here's first and 10. A shotgun snap for Tua. To the left side, OBJ is there. After the catch, he gets that forward for a gain of 9. Second and a yard. Out of the gun, Tagovailoa. Over the middle, it's taken in by Waddle. And this drive's going to continue. He's taken down, but they are set up with first and goal. Here's a run. And he's going the wrong way. Dropped back at the 7.
That was just a race to the edge. And in this case, Mike, he just wasn't the winner. I mean, at this point, when the defense is out there waiting for you, it's tough for any runner in this league to even get back to the original line of scrimmage.
Now from the 7, it's 2nd and goal. Hill brought in motion. Using the jet sweep for the fake, they run it up the middle. And he keeps the legs moving, able to get it down inside the 5. Third and goal. From the gun, here's Tua. What a half he is putting together. That's his 3rd touchdown already. This is turning into a monster game. Let's keep an eye on this. 3 touchdown catches alone in the first half. Could be a record-setting game. Sanders here for the extra point. It's up and good. And the Dolphins add on one more as they extend their 2nd quarter lead. After the touchdown, Myers is back to boot this one away. Here's Smith to return it. And a decent return there. He'll get this up just shy of the 30. First and 10. Play action, Stafford. Open downfield is Parkinson. And he's taken down inside the opponent's 35. A big play to kick off this drive. 39 yards. For me here in this first half. Greg and I return to SoFi Stadium after a short break. On first down, Stafford. They'll be forced to just throw that one away. It's incomplete.
You know, it's hard to speculate, Mike. We sit up here and we try to just interpret and assume what's going on in the minds of the players and the minds of the coaches, but they seem to me to be a little bit rattled. All these negative plays have really started to pile up in the first half. He's got to settle down, have some more efficiency on these early downs, and get his offense into some sort of rhythm.
That's called in on the left by Nakua. Here's a third down and four. They'll throw once more. Here's Stafford. And he will have the first down. The drive will continue after a pickup of eight. Again is Stafford. Hop brings it in left side. And he's close to another first down as he's brought down just shy of the marker. A good spot here. Second and a yard. Stafford to throw again. He'll get this complete. It's Cup again. And he'll be out of bounds, but he got the first down, so it's going to be first and goal. They're going to mark it at the six. To the air again. Stafford. Here's a screen set up to Williams. And he gets out wide. He'll go to the end zone. Tyron Williams. Touchdown, LA. Cardi now to add the extra point. The kick is good. And the Rams are able to cut the deficit. It's now 28-17. Still a little time. Final minute of this first half. We'll see if they can do anything with this kickoff that is coming their way. He'll work his way across the 25-yard line. First set of downs to work with. It is first down and 10. Throwing is Tua. This throw right side is caught by him. And they bring him down, but not until he gets the 45-yard line. On first down, here's Tagovailoa to throw. He'll go right and find his running back. They face second down and 7. Tua. That one into the hands of Hill. And they'll move this one down inside the 40-yard line. Now a 1st and 10 from the 38-yard line. To the air again, Tagovailoa sending it deep for Waddle. And they're going to get this all the way down inside the 5. And with just 4 seconds left in the first half, a timeout is called.
The offense is able to land a big blow there, and I think what happened defensively, Mike, is just everyone was not on the same page. And when you do that at this level, the good offenses, they're going to make you pay for it. They've got to clean up those mistakes, make the offense have to earn everything they get.
Jason Sanders on to try the field goal. This, about as short as you can get. Sanders' kick is good. And the Dolphins going to tack on 3 more, extending the lead here late in the first half.
And that's a really nice boost here before the break. I mean, you work the clock well. You're able to steal some points. The biggest thing is you're able to build a little momentum now going into the locker room at halftime.
So 2 seconds left to play, and the kick's away. This one is fielded in the end zone, but he will not bring it out. It's a touchback, and this drive will begin at the 30-yard line. First down, Stafford. Taking the deep shot here with Robinson. And it's incomplete. And it looked like early contact. Let's check the call. So on comes Joshua Cardy to try this field goal. This from extra point range, a 33-yard field goal attempt. He is 2 for 2. That kick is good. So we've reached halftime here in this 11-point game as we send you back east to sunny Florida. Standing by with our EA Sports Halftime Report, it's the coach, Jonathan Coachman.
Okay, Mike, thank you. More from you and Greg in a moment, but for now, welcome one and all to our EA Sports Halftime Report. The Dolphins got some strong play out of their quarterback number one, Tua Tagovailoa. He's over 300 yards passing already as he's looking to possibly put his name in the record book.
Coach, thank you. Not a rest at the break for the defensive coordinators trying to figure out how to stop these offenses as we get ready for the second half. First half played out a bit as we expected. We'll see if there's a surprise coming up. Both teams set to go, and the second half is underway. And they bring down just shy of the 30-yard line. Matthew Stafford and the Rams offense getting set to go again. And he has been a nightmare to scheme against throughout this one. This defense has been picked apart. That is borne out in those impressive numbers. He has been terrific all game long. They'll go with Williams. daylight. Up past the 35-yard line, a pickup of 7. Here's 2nd and 3 to go. From the gun, here's Stafford. And the out of bounds, it's a gain of 4, and that gains them another first down. Now Stafford. Throw right side, Holt in by Cup. They'll work now on 2nd and 4. Cup in motion. And show jet sweep and instead run it up the middle. Maybe a couple there. It's 3rd down. Out of the gun, Stafford. That finds the pull-out along the sideline. Here's a handoff to Williams. Not much there, maybe a yard. Here's 2nd and 9. Working out of the gun, Stafford. That one on target to Cup. And they'll work this close to a first down, maybe just a tad short. They'll empty out the backfield as they come up for 3rd and a yard. From the shotgun, it's Stafford. He'll look middle and he's got his man complete.
I just love the feel this tight end has, Mike, for the defense when they play zone coverage. Certain guys, they want to run routes like their lines on a piece of paper, and they end up going from uncovered space to covered space, but not the case here. He knew he was open. He knew he was in the right spot. He stayed open. The quarterback delivered a good ball.
On the give, it's Williams. Nice gain on first down, but the penalty flags come in. The question now, will the play stand? Now it's Stafford. This one taken in by Parkinson. Again, it's Stafford. Third and long. The shotgun snap to Stafford.
This game is kind of getting to the point, Mike, where it's defense optional. I mean, both these teams are really just having their way with their opponent. They're going up and down the field. And after this long touchdown, yes, this is great if you're a fantasy player, but it's not so great if you're a defensive coordinator.
Stafford brings the Rams to the line. They'll try to get two. Blitz coming. He'll throw it. And that is incomplete. Two-point conversion attempt winds up being unsuccessful.
Mike, there's not a lot of ways to break this play down other than saying you get the wide-open target, you have the play you want, you're aggressive going for two. You just got to catch the ball.
Here's Carney now. He'll kick it away following the touchdown. Washington now to return it. And it'll be brought down past the 25. Decent field position to start this drive. Now, Tua and the Miami offense head out for their next possession. And we show you some of the highlights, and there have been plenty to choose from. Three touchdown passes and some other big-time throws as well. Certainly dialed in and on top of his game right throughout this one. They'll come up here first and 10. They'll motion the tight end, Smith. He'll start on the ground. It's Achane. And he is going to be stuck well behind the line of scrimmage. That play going absolutely nowhere. So after the loss on first, here's second and 14. From the gun, here's Tua.
Brings up third and long, and most of the time is a very pass-happy situation, makes them very one-dimensional.
So backed up after the sack, and now it's third and long. Now it's Tua. And third down, incomplete. Hulk team headed out for the Dolphins. He'll hit this from just outside of his own goal line. And he's going to be hit and dropped right away. That's great coverage there. Winds up with nothing on the return. They go play action with Stafford. His throw on first down is going to be incomplete. Try again. It's second and 10. Back to throw. Stafford. Open man is Robinson. And they'll move this one down inside the 40-yard line.
Now, so far here today, putting points on the board certainly hasn't been a problem, and plays like that are why. Think about it, Mike. Sometimes you just have to take what the defense gives you and not force something that's not there, and that mid-range pass results in a fresh set of downs.
Ball rests at the 37. It's first and 10. On the carry, it's Williams. He'll manage only a couple. Chop Robinson, the rookie out of Penn State, in there for the stop. Second down and 8. They'll fake the handoff. Now Stafford. The second down throw is incomplete. They need to get it to the 27. This is third down. Here's Stafford. And this ball incomplete on third down.
This is teach tape for man defense, Mike. I mean, he is not looking back at the quarterback at all. He is in the hip pocket of his receiver. He's staying in phase and in rhythm. And then he knows when the wide receiver's hands go up, attack the ball. And that's about as good as it gets.
Three for three in the game, as this one is also good. And the Rams will cut the deficit down to 2. Back out following the made field goal. He'll kick this one away. Washington now to return it. He'll get across the 20, bump him down to 23-yard line. The Dolphins offense and Tua Tagovailoa making their way back out. And he's had it going in the first half. Really had his way with the secondary. They have been powerless to stop him. Now they'll try to keep it going. From their own 23, they'll begin first and 10. In motion comes Beckham. On play action, it's Tagovailoa. Sending it deep for Waddle. And that is incomplete.
You talk about a quarterback getting bailed out. Man, that is a pick all day long. And as this defender enters the huddle, you see a bunch of his guys hitting him on the helmet, but I can promise you, they're saying, next time, you got to come down with that.
They'll motion the tight end, Smith. To throw on second down, it's 2. To throw there, but not on the same page for this time. That's incomplete. He was trying to get it to Odell Beckham Jr. there, and it'll be third down. Shotgun snap to 2. He's going to air this one out. Looking for her. Incomplete. No separation that time. Tightly defended. It brings up fourth down.
Every so often, Mike, you can see these offenses, and it looks like the passing game gets a little bit too predictable. And as the defense continues to flood the back end of these zones with extra defenders, you're continuing to force this quarterback to not only make some difficult throws, but to put the ball in harm's way.
And and he'll get forward a few yards on the return. And that's where the offense will take over. First and 10 now from the 36. They send the tight end in motion. Stafford gets this one out quick to McCool. He's got a touchdown on the books from earlier, and that catch gets him a first down. The motion man is Nacua. Stafford now to throw on first down. The middle, it's caught. And they'll move this one down inside the 40-yard line. Break the huddle. Coming up now for first and 10. On the ground, this is Williams. And good blocking up front, paving the way for a gain of 8 on the ground. They'll come to the line now on second and 2. On the play fake, here's Stafford. That's to Robinson, he's got it. And they're in great shape. He's taken down inside the 10. Ball resting on the 9. First down and goal. Stafford now.
The offense goes from feeling really good about the previous play with a real nice pickup to then on the ensuing play ending up going the complete opposite direction. Really nice job here by the defense immediately getting back on track. And what do the coaches say? Just play the next play. And that's exactly what they did.
First down was not very good. Here's second and goal. Here's the give up the middle with Williams. And he'll be taken down, but now a long way to go on third and goal. Now Stafford on third and goal.
When a defense has speed to the ball like this group does, it makes these wide receiver screens really challenging because all those fast linebackers and defensive backs that are chasing the ball carrier, the offensive line are the ones responsible for them, and sometimes that's just a speed mismatch and they can't get out in front.
Another one. Through the uprights. He's 4-for-4 on the game. And the Rams will take the lead here in the third quarter. Back out following the main field goal. He'll kick this one away. Washington now to return it. saying he'll be brought down just beyond the 25-yard line. The Dolphins offense and their quarterback set to take the field once more. And you get a look at the numbers, they don't even tell the whole story. This has been a tremendous performance to this point. So they come to the line for first down and 10. In motion, it's Waddle. A run with the fullback, Engle. They're trying to use that size to push forward, but it's not going to work. Defense strong up front. They're going to get him down behind the line of scrimmage.
When you give the ball to the fullback, it just hits a lot faster, so it puts a lot of pressure on the defense to trust their reads and react. It's exactly what we saw here. They're able to take him down in the backfield for a loss.
Now, AJ. And they're going to mark him down up past the 35.
Remember this one thing. It is not how well or how often you run the ball in the NFL. It's when do you run the ball well in the NFL. And I think that's what a lot of these offensive play callers are starting to realize. Can you run the ball well in critical moments of the game? More important than how many gross yards you run for.
Out of the pistol, here's Tua. And he slides and covers up at the end, avoids the hit, and picked up decent yardage along the way. So, no shortage of offense in this one as we end the third. Back with more Monday Night Football after this. They'll come up here on second down and 5. In motion, it's Waddle. They fake the jet sweep and they'll hand it up the middle. And that one is closed down in the backfield. What a defensive play. Knifing in, dropping him for the loss. Big play coming up. This is third down. Out of the gun, Tungo Bailoa. It'll put him over 200 receiving yards in the game. What a performance. That grab also comes with a first down.
And how about the poise of this quarterback? You find yourself down here late in the fourth quarter, Mike, facing a tough third down. You've got to have it. You know what? He calls the play. He breaks the huddle. He's like, you know what, coach? I got it. That's a big-time throw to now keep this drive alive as they go down looking for that go-ahead touchdown.
And they bring him down, but not until they get inside the 30-yard line.
Well, there's not a whole lot of fancy going on here, Mike. This is just kind of old school, line up and run smash mouth football. It's exactly what they did, but it still ends up in a big game, and he picks up the first down.
Here's first and 10. In motion, it's Waddle. Off play action, it's Tua. Now a deep ball toward the end zone.
I can tell you from firsthand experience, Mike, that is a lonely and long jog back to the huddle. I mean, you're an inch away from being the hero with a deep touchdown. Instead, you let it go through your fingertips, and you got to come back to the huddle and try again.
They'll keep it on the ground. And they only managed to pick up 3 yards. And that leads to third down. He'll run. Thank you. here comes Jason Sanders in a big spot. This to take the lead here in the fourth. And this one, right down the middle. It's good. And they take the lead here in the fourth quarter. So, after the field goal to take the lead, kicker is back out there to send this one away. Here's Smith to return it. A good return as he takes it across the 30. Rams offense, running back Kyren Williams, ready to go once more. And he has put in a full game's work and then some. Just an incredible performance on the ground to this point in the fourth quarter. First down, Stafford. And he can't hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. What a good job defensively to meet him just as the ball was arriving. And it'll be second down. They'll run here. He will not be able to get free, picking up only a yard. Now, it's third down. Out of the gun, Stafford. And that is incomplete.
The relationship between the pass rush and the pass coverage is critical. The better you rush the passer, the more pressure you can take off your coverage, and that's a great example why.
Punt team headed out for the Rams. They'll be forced to punt, trailing here in the fourth quarter. Taken at the 19. And it'll be brought down, short return, and they'll take over there. First and 10. In motion, it's Waddle. On first down, Tagovailoa. Position now takes the lead, Greg, by taking it to the end zone.
And it seems like week in and week out, Mike, in this league, there's one or two plays that determine the outcome of the game. And I get the sense here in the second half, that game-changing scoop and score by this defense could very well be that play.
On comes Joshua Cardy for the extra point. He knocks it through. And the Rams will up the lead to 5. So now playing with the lead after that fourth quarter touchdown. Time to kick it back the other way. Washington now to return it. Across the 20, they'll mark him down before the 25-yard line. That's where the offense will take over. So here's a first and 10 now. They'll start from the 24. Hill brought in motion. Fake the handoff. Now, two. Under pressure, and he'll go down. They got it.
They probably would have been better off just handing the ball off to the running back, Mike, because when they used him as a decoy, nobody fell for it. By the time he finished his fake and got his head around, the defense was all over.
The loss of three in his second and 13. They'll step to the ground. Up the sideline at the 35. And he'll wind up out of bounds past the 45-yard line. That one good for 26 yards.
Watch the running back's patience here, Mike. He's slow, and then he hits it. That's the key here. If he goes too fast, their linemen aren't ready yet. Really well executed. Great run.
Set to go now on first and 10. In motion, it's Waddle. And no chance to turn and go. That one good for just a couple. Look him up on a second down and 8. They'll motion the tight end, Smith. On the carry, here's Achane. And some good blocking at the point of attack. A pickup of 7, and it brings up third down.
Decision-making is critical. Not only is he able to extend the drive by picking up the first down with his legs, great jump by the quarterback, understanding, get out of bounds, stop the clock, save as much time as possible as they try to make a comeback.
In motion, it's Waddle. Tua, give it to Achan. The defense all over this one. They get him behind the line of scrimmage. A loss of a couple. Last play went the wrong way. It sets up second and long. It's second down and 12. The NFL's leader in rushing touchdowns last year, Raheem Mostert. They get 18 on that one. Good for a Dolphins first down.
This is a guy who's been doing it at a high level, Mike, for a long time. Not too many running backs finding success in the NFL past the age of 30. That's usually when they kind of ride off into the sunset. But as always, there's the exception to every rule.
Well, fake the hand. Now, Tua. He's got it at the 7. That's a gain of 16 yards, and it sets up first and goal.
The That's a really important pickup there on that last completion. Not only does it set up first and goal, but allows everybody in the huddle to just take a deep breath. We're no longer in this frantic offensive possession. Let's get our best play. Let's make sure everyone understands what to do, because we know we need to finish this off with six if we can. And now being first and goal is going to go a long way in allowing that to be possible.
Down to the goal line. No signal. Is he in? They'll say it did not break the play, but a real solid gain on first and goal. Second and goal. They'll run with Mostert. Raheem Mostert, touchdown Miami. A lot of big bodies down there, but at the end of the day, the one that mattered, the one with the ball, finds the end zone for the touchdown.
Yeah, once that back gets the ball, Mike, he's just looking for a little crack of daylight, and he's thinking, I'm going to run into it and just hope I come out the other side. And in this case, the other side's the end zone, and they get six.
Now a big play here. Dolphins will go for two. Tua. And that is incomplete. They get the touchdown, take the lead, but it remains a one-point game. So now playing with the lead after that fourth quarter touchdown. Time to kick it back the other way. Very good kickoff. Returnable from the four. And he is stopped at the 25. The drive will begin there. A fresh set of downs to work with. It is first down and 10. Gets it away quickly, and it's caught. We'll get him up four here as he is taken down. Here's second and six. A give, and here comes Williams. And that was set up now. Up past the 40 with that one.
Really well executed counter run there, Mike. And what you're trying to do anytime on these misdirection schemes is you're trying to get these linebackers that might play at a 4-5 speed to maybe play at a 4-7 speed. The hesitation, not understanding exactly where the ball is going to end up, gives you an advantage offensively, just like we saw here.
First down throw there is incomplete.
I think that play probably results in a completion if that protection just holds up a little bit longer. It was that initial pressure in the face of the quarterback that forced him to get rid of that ball a little bit earlier than he wanted. Disrupts that timing, ruins the play.
On play action, it's Stafford. A throw there on second down, going to be incomplete.
Defense got lucky on that one. There's no one accounting for the running back out of the backfield as they should have, and fortunately for them, he bails him out by not securing the catch.
So after back-to-back incompletions, it is now third and 10. From the gun, here's Stafford. And that is incomplete.
This passing game, like, it just seems a bit erratic. On top of the two straight incompletions, they've already turned the ball over through the air. Truthfully, with how dangerous some of these throws have been, they're lucky it hasn't been even more.
The Rams punting unit coming out, as he'll come on to kick for the fifth time here tonight. He'll take this in back at the 16. And he's going to be brought down after a short return. And that's where his team will get possession of the football. This drive starts at the 21. It's first and 10. They're trying to burn some clock here as we keep it on the ground. And that one shut down pretty quickly. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage. Nothing more.
Depending on the situation or the down and distance, Mike, the linebackers have different reads. Sometimes they read the offensive lineman. Sometimes they read the running back. In this case, his read brings him right to the play. He's able to make a big stop and keep the game to nothing.
Once again, it's A-Chain. Trying to find someplace to go, but nothing developing. Tackled behind the line. It's a loss of one.
Well, now this brings up third down, Mike, and a really tough call for this coach. Does he want to remain aggressive, put the ball in the air, and try to keep this offense on the field? Or can he be a little more conservative, not be afraid to punt the ball away, and hope his defense can finish this game out?
This crowd into it now as we get to third down. They'll drop to throw. Team comes out, Dolphins going to kick it away. As they try to play the field position game here, protecting a fourth quarter lead. And the receiver with a fair catch, taken successfully. And that's where he'll turn it over to the offense. Here is first and 10. Working out of the gun, Stafford. And this ball batted away and incomplete.
That's one of those plays where you come off the field, Mike, and you're getting a lot of high fives. Hey, good job. But then that secondary's coach pulls you over to the side and says, hey, nice play. But next time, let's come away with the pick.
Here's second down. The shotgun, it's Stafford. A gain there of 11. Good for a Rams first down.
All right, this is a good start. Plays like these are definitely going to help as you work your way into scoring range. While you have to be wary of the clock and keep an eye on it, they should have plenty of time here to finish this drive.
Going to use the first of their timeouts, and they'll get together prior to the second down play. Shotgun snap to Stafford. Nakua snags it over the middle. And that'll go for a gain of 7. And it's going to set up third down. Stafford. And the rush gets there. Down he goes.
I see a lot of tired legs out there on both sides of the field, Mike. Looks like this pass rush has found a little bit of a second wind. They come away with a big-time sack, and it brings up fourth down.
Defense has to play smart, avoid a penalty on fourth and long. They'll snap it. Here's Stafford taking the deep shot here with Robinson. And that is incomplete. They had their chance. He took it there. Look, they're trailing late. Got to let it fly. This will wind up a turnover on downs.
Finding yourself down to your final timeout, this is the moment. This is the drive that you have to find a way to extend if you're going to claw yourself back into this game. But the defense comes up with a huge stop, and that will all but end this game.
They'll come up here first and 10. Tua to take a knee, and that should be the final act in this one. Lost one on the last play, so now it's second and 11. Victory formation here as he's down to a knee. So a win here for the Dolphins. This was a game where both offenses were up and down the field, marching the ball at will, matching each other point for point. But in the end, got a few more defensive stops than their opponents did. And that was the difference in this one. So that'll just about do it for Greg Olson and our entire team. I'm Mike Tirico. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to EASports.com. Good night, everybody.